Hi, let's talk about the nerves of the orbit. The orbit is served by many different cranial nerves and branches of cranial nerves. I've included the brainstem model with many of these images so that we can appreciate and understand where these nerves are coming from. So let's start with the optic nerve. The optic nerve, cranial nerve 2, emerges from the optic chiasm. And here we can see that stump. The optic nerve is found in association with the ophthalmic artery as it is traversing the optic canal. Cranial nerve 3, or the oculomotor nerve, we can see here, so this is 3, is going to move through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus before entering the orbit through the superior orbital fissure. Cranial nerve 4, or the trochlear nerve, which we can see there and there, is going to be just adjacent to the oculomotor nerve as it moves through the wall of the cavernous sinus. Cranial nerve 5, or the trigeminal nerve, is located there on the brainstem model. We can see that here, and we know that it has 3 divisions. So here we can see V1. That goes through the superior orbital fissure. There's V2 through foramen rotundum. And there is V3 that goes through foramen ovale. The 6th cranial nerve, or the abducens, is right there on the brainstem model. And here we can see the abducens moving through the cavernous sinus on its way out to the orbit through the superior orbital fissure. So let's take a look, a closer look at the optic nerve. I'll just highlight it again here on the brainstem. We can see the optic nerve there. It's traveling through the optic canal there, and we can catch up with that optic nerve again here as it's going out to directly serve the eye. The oculomotor nerve is here on the brainstem. We can see the oculomotor nerve in part here. This would be the inferior division of the oculomotor nerve. And then there will be other branches of it. You can see a little bit of that right along there. We also have the trochlear nerve. Trochlear nerve is located there. The trochlear nerve serves superior oblique, so that's where you should be looking for it. We can get a really fantastic view of the trochlear nerve there. Recall that the superior oblique muscle runs through the trochlea, which is a cartilaginous pulley attached to the frontal bone. So trochlear, superior oblique. The ophthalmic nerve, or ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve, is very frequently referred to as V1, and it has 3 major branches: the frontal nerve, the lacrimal nerve, and the nasociliary nerve, and each of those branches will also have branches. The lacrimal nerve, we can see here, moving out to the lacrimal gland. That's special sensory for the lacrimal gland. The preganglionic parasympathetic fibers are coming from the facial nerve. They synapse in the pterygopalatine ganglion, and postganglionic fibers are going to hitchhike to the lacrimal gland via branches of V2. The lacrimal nerve is the smallest branch of V1, and you should be looking for it in the superolateral margin of the orbit. The frontal nerve is the most robust branch of V1, and we can see the frontal nerve heading out here. Frontal nerve has two major branches. There is the supraorbital nerve, which is typically the larger of the two. And then the trochlear nerve. The supraorbital nerve is more medial, whereas the trochlear nerve is more medial. Also, that supraorbital nerve is going to have both medial and lateral branches. And oftentimes, people will confuse that medial branch of the supraorbital nerve with the trochlear nerve. That trochlear nerve is going to be much more medially oriented, heading out toward the trochlea. So keep an eye on that. The nasociliary nerve is more deep. We can't see that without removing levator palpebrae superioris and superior rectus muscles. The abducens is the last cranial nerve to discuss. It's cranial nerve 6 going out to the lateral rectus muscle, which we can see here. The abducens travels through the cavernous sinus on its way to the lateral rectus muscle. The lateral rectus muscle abducts the eye, and I remember that the abducens nerve abducts gaze. So abducens abducts by innervating the lateral rectus. And we can see the abducens on the brainstem model there. Now let's get around to that elusive branch of V1, the nasociliary. We can see that trunk there. So the nasociliary is going to give rise to the long ciliary nerves, which innervate the eye. It's also going to give rise to the ethmoidal nerves, which innervate the ethmoidal air cells, as well as part of the nose. And then it terminates as the infratrochlear nerve. The nasociliary nerve, among other nerves, including oculomotor, as well as some sympathetic branches, are going to head out to the ciliary ganglion, which we can see there. The ciliary ganglion is just lateral adjacent to the optic nerve, and it communicates with the eye via these short ciliary nerves. So we've discussed the various nerves which serve the orbit as well as their branches. Thank you for your time.